When most people think of tall volcanoes, a number of stunning peaks come to mind. Mount Rainier, Kilimanjaro, and Ojos de Salado are three such examples. Yet, none of these towering volcanoes even compare in size to what is the tallest and largest volcano in our solar system, Olympus Mons. Olympus Mons rises from the Tharsis Montes region of Mars to an altitude of 22 kilometers or 72,000 feet. Combining with its height, this truly special volcanic wonder of our solar system is also stunningly large. In fact, the edifice of Olympus Mons is comparable in size to the US state of Arizona or the nation of Poland. With this being said, Olympus Mons' size is not its only fantastical feature. To prove my point, here is an example with distances overlaid on Earth. What if I were to tell you that a volcano, which doesn't exist by the way, in Anaheim, California, had sent magma to the east, and that it would soon cause lava to eventually erupt all the way in Arlington, Texas? This might seem absurd, but Olympus Mons actually caused incredibly distant flank eruptions to occur during its past as much as 2,000 kilometers or 1,248 miles away from its summit. Adding to this, despite how eroded sections of Olympus Mons might appear, it is quite likely to one day erupt again. Why do I say this? Simply put, because of an interesting young-looking lava delta-like feature on Mons' southwestern slope, where an older landslide deposit was seemingly overlaid with basaltic lava flows that appear to be as little as 2 to 30 million years old based on the number of impact craters it contains. Before I continue, I would like to discuss this video's sole sponsor, YouTube. YouTube is offering everyone, and I mean everyone, a 2-month free trial instead of the regular 1 month for an ad-free experience of YouTube via YouTube Premium. YouTube Premium not only offers an ad-free experience, but also allows you to download any video if you have cellular data or Wi-Fi for later watching. A great usage of this tool is to download videos before you go to a foreign country or, if you are like me, to a remote volcano. You can even download several hour-long podcast episodes. But there is more. YouTube Premium allows you to continue watching where you left off after switching devices and gives you ad-free access to music in YouTube's music app. Additionally, a portion of the fee you pay for YouTube Premium goes to creators based on what you view during your subscription. Come try out YouTube Premium today via a 2-month free trial with my special affiliate link shown on screen and in this video's description. If you end up subscribing to YouTube Premium during or at the end of your free trial, I may get a commission. Olympus Mons is located in the figurative tropics of Mars as it is only 1,000 kilometers north of the planet's equator. Before I explain how old Olympus Mons is, I need to first elaborate as to why this volcano is so big. The short answer is that unlike Earth, Mars never had plate tectonics. As a result, when mantle hotspots occur on the planet, the overlying crust does not move. Instead of creating a chain of islands like you would on Earth, it instead creates a supermassive volcano in a central point above the hotspot that keeps growing and growing until the hotspot feeding it has subsided. Olympus Mons is the largest example of hotspot volcanism on Mars, representing a supermassive shield volcano. Although we aren't exactly sure how old the volcano is, current estimates suggest that Olympus Mons began forming 3.5 billion years ago. The initial eruptions from Olympus Mons were voluminous and likely created spectacularly tall fountains of lava due to the low gravity on the planet. Also, as a consequence of Mars's lower gravity, the flows of molten rock had lower mass, meaning they had lower friction, which caused them to travel much further than they would have on Earth. These effusive eruptions likely had eruptive rates upwards of 1,000 or even 10,000 cubic meters per second, involving basaltic lava which moved at a speed of 5 miles or 8 kilometers per hour. Many flank eruptions also occurred, with lava spreading out to build a supermassive gentle-sloped edifice. After many millions of years of near-constant eruptions, Olympus Mons had become a several-thousand-meter-tall volcano which was 800 kilometers wide. At some point during the early geologic history of Olympus Mons, it was surrounded on all sides by a shallow ocean. As such, Olympus Mons became an island and was subjected to significant quantities of erosion from movement of the water. The erosion eventually formed a series of prominent cliffs, which represented a departure from the typical shallow 5-degree slopes on this volcano. During the repeated episodes of erosion, several megatsunamis were generated by partial flank collapses of Olympus Mons. One of these landslides more than a billion years ago deposited material 700 kilometers to the north of the volcano. Eventually, the vast oceans on Mars disappeared and Olympus Mons continued to be built through largely effusive eruptions. Some batches of its magma had by this time experienced fractional crystallization, causing about 1% of Olympus Mons to become composed of more viscous and slower-moving basaltic andesite lava rock. Some of these eruptions were even slightly explosive, producing small quantities of ash since more gas could build up underneath more viscous lavas, along with occasional magma interacting with frozen ice deposited on its slopes. By 500 million years ago, with a greatly diminished eruptive rate, Olympus Mons was essentially its modern height. Then, 420 million years ago, a large quantity of lava erupted at a location several hundred to several thousand kilometers away from the summit of Olympus Mons. Just like recent large volume eruptions at Kilauea in Hawaii, this caused a large section of the caldera to collapse, forming a 25 kilometer wide caldera. Over the next several hundred million years, five more of these calderas formed on Olympus Mons. The last of these formed 140 million years ago. More recent eruptions at Olympus Mons have occurred at least a half dozen times in the last 100 million years, perhaps including as little as 2 million years ago. While I personally doubt that Olympus Mons will erupt anytime soon, I suggest that its current eruptive frequency is at least once every 10 million years.